Okay, so now let's start understanding where actually we need to make a projection of our object. So let me just draw a quadrant system over here, a basic quadrant system with four quadrants. You probably know that. So this will be our first quadrant, this is our second, this is our third, and this is our fourth. And these lines represent our horizontal plane and vertical plane. Let me just name them quickly. So this is our vertical plane and this is our horizontal plane. Now when we say that object is above HP, that means above this line. So this object will lie on this end over here. And the question again says that it is also in front of VP. So this means that the object will lie on this side. So this side we can name as above HP and front of VP. So this section will be defined as above HP and front of VP. Similarly, this section will be above HP. But as you can see that it is on the left side of the virtual plane over here, or the vertical plane, sorry. So this will be behind VP. Just like so. Now moving in the fourth quadrant. Third quadrant, so now moving in the third quadrant right over here, this section over here. This will be defined as our below HP, also behind VP. Now let's move on to the fourth quadrant. This will be our below HP and front of VP. Now we can divide, as we have divided into four different aspects, now we can go ahead and explain where the projection will lie on the XY line. So let's draw a XY line for this purpose. This is our XY line. Let's name it. Okay, so let's take our first condition. If our object is in our first quadrant, that is above HP and in front of VP, then from seeing it from the front view, so let's say we are viewing from here to here. Here's the object, and we are viewing from here. So if you view it from here, you can see that it is above HP. So this image will lie on the top of the XY line. That means if I draw a circle in the first quadrant, the front view will be on the top. Just like so. Don't worry about the scale, I am not making it to the scale. And if you view it from the top, it will actually fall behind, below the VP. So the top view will lie beneath the XY line, just like so. And again, I am not drawing it to scale, so I'm just showing that where the object will lie. Now let's talk about our second quadrant, above HP and behind VP. So for that, we will also draw a new XY line over here. And let's say our circle is on this second quadrant. So the above HP means, as you can see, if you view it from this side and view it from here, it will be above the HP line. So the front view will be on the top of the XY line. Now if you view it from the top, it will actually be above the VP line. That means it will also be above the XY line. So the top view will also be above the XY line, just like so. Now, when we talk about the third quadrant, it is just a reverse process of the first quadrant. So the front view will actually go to the bottom and the top view will go to the top. Now, when we talk about the third quadrant, it is just opposite to the first quadrant. So the top view will become the front view and the front view will become the top view. That means the front view will actually go below the XY line and the top view will go above the XY line. Now, when we talk about the third quadrant, it is just a reverse condition of the first quadrant over here. So in the first quadrant, the top view is below the XY line and the front view is above the XY line. So in the third quadrant, the top view will be above the XY line and the front view will be below the XY line. And this is a similar condition in the fourth quadrant as well. So in the fourth quadrant, it's a reverse condition for second quadrant. So in the fourth quadrant, both the objects will lie below the XY line, just like so. So this is our first and this is our second. Let me just move it here so you don't get confused, just like so. And these are not represented as scale, I just showing you the objects where will they lie. So you only need to remember these two conditions and then you can just make a reverse of them in the diagonal fashion, just like so. So this is all about the XY line and where to project them, if they are above HP or below HP or behind VP or in front of VP.